discuss a controversial subject.
Yes. There's going to be lots of talking.
We wanted to make this video since it has been, how many months now? 2-3 months?
Yes.
Since we installed our solar system.
Mm-hmm.
And we get many, many questions on how it is going. And to give you guys a little bit more detail and a breakdown of what we did and how much it actually costs.
Yes.
So we're just going to take this time, sit with you, go through everything that we have done and our experience with the Huawei system during this coldest part of the Mongolian winter.
Yes. I'm writing down everything in here. So let's start.
Yeah. First of all, we did not get paid by Huawei to make any sort of videos for them, but they did give us a really good discount to put in that system, which made it extremely affordable for us. We couldn't say no to that kind of offer.
Mm-hmm.
But we are being very clear that we want to give you all the information, whether it's good or not. So far, we're very happy with the system.
Really good timing.
Really, really good timing. It has been a dream of ours to go on solar here in Mongolia because it makes a huge difference with the amount of sun that we get here on our homestead, or the amount of sun you get here in Mongolia.
Yes.
Yeah. We started the project, 3 months ago? 4 months ago?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. 3-4 months ago. We decided to do a tilt adjustable mount because you get quite a lot of degree change between the summer and the winter. Here in Mongolia, the sun angle at its highest point in the day in winter time goes down to about 18 degrees, and summer it's quite high.
Yes.
Can't remember the exact number.
Yep.
Yeah. So we decided to do a tilt adjustable system where we can actually make the changes on the solar panels so we can change them to the winter time and to the summertime.
Yeah, we are doing a lot of research. So most of Mongolian people, they don't choose the tilt as adjustable. So we are...
They normally keep it at 45 degrees. Winter, summer, they just leave it like that.
Yes. And then we're doing lots of research and how to do it and low cost as possible.
Mm. So. We were trying to find material. We've seen a lot of videos on how to build a mount for the solar panels, especially with finding aluminum. It's quite expensive.
Mm.
You get the U brackets and things like that. It worked out to be quite a lot more. So we decided to build it from steel, which is a little bit cheaper. Of course, we will have to maintain it, keep it painted. And if it gets any rust on it, we would have to grind it off and repaint it. But it outweighs the cost, I think, quite a lot.
Yeah.
The solar panels, we've got 18 550-watt Jinko Tiger series. That will give us a 10-kilowatt solar array. We did that into two strings. We have 9 solar panels on one string and 9 solar panels on the other string.
Yep.
But you can either do them in series or you can do them parallel. It's just how you connect them up, and it'll make a difference in the voltage. For our circumstance, for our solar system inverter that we were going to put in, it was better to do it in two strings.
Yes.
We're going to go through some of the costs so you guys know what a type of system we have and how it all works.
Yeah.
Okay.
So first of all, we are building our tilt.
Yep, we built the tilt ourselves.
Mm.
So labor cost is, nothing.
Nothing.
Just we rented some equipment.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then we use a lot of metals for this because our tilt is adjustable.
Mm-hmm.
So it's much more metals we used.
Yep.
So all the metal that costs were 1 million turuk, and that which means $293
for all the metal.
Yes.
Yeah.
All the extra costs and paint and concrete mixer and things all together is 1,371,000 total, which means it's about $400.
About $400 for the actual mount to hold 18 solar panels.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
For only tilt.
Yeah.
We built.
And then the solar panels themselves, so it's 18 550-watt Jinkos.
Yes. Each cost is 760,000 Tugruk.
Yep.
Which means like $223.
Yeah.
Each.
Exactly. And we got those from Clean Resource Development here in Mongolia. There are lots of companies here selling solar panels.
Yes.
So you kind of just really need to look into the actual solar panel that you're getting.
They're
pretty much all coming in from China.
Exactly, yeah. Hmm? And also choose like 450 or 550 volts. And
we decided, because we are a little bit limited on space, so we got slightly bigger solar panels with a higher range, so we can have less solar panels.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Once we have the ground mount and we installed the solar panels, we also put on a splitter box, because we have two strings going to the splitter box. Inside the splitter box, we have two fuse boxes. Those have both got 16 amp fuses, which go to two breaker switches. Before that actually goes to our house, we didn't need to put surge controllers inside the breaker box.
Yes.
Because we have surge controllers inside our Huawei Smart PV. They have AC and DC surge controllers.
Yeah.
Plus, depending on what country you are, they have different regulations. Here we could just use DC breaker switches. We didn't have to have a quick disconnect, because that is not, we're not legally bound to have that in Mongolia. Where other countries, like in the States, you would have to have a quick disconnect. So how much for the box, breakers, and cabling?
Yeah,
how much cables did we use?
That's a cable, that's a special cable. That's called MC4.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's a special cable for a solar panel to connect with the inverter. And then total is a 320 meters we're using.
Yep.
And that's cost like 1,440,000 for
the cables.
The cables. Yeah, and then also we need that connections, and that's cost each the 4,500 each, and then total cost of 45,000.
So what was the cost of the whole mount plus the solar panels and all the cables to connect it up?
Yeah, the solar panel and all electric cables and things all costs like about 15 million Tugruk.
15 million Tugruk.
Yeah.
How much is that in dollars?
Yeah, $4,500.
$4,500.
About, yeah.
Yeah.
Roughly.
Roughly, which I think from what we've seen is quite a lot cheaper than doing it in America.
But we didn't add on the inverter and battery.
That's just that. Then it comes to, I mean, once you've done the solar mount and you have done the solar panels, then it comes to what you're going to do. If you're going to be completely off-grid, what type of batteries you're going to put in, what type of charge controller, things like that.
Yeah.
We were approached by Clean Resources Development, so we are working with them. So we got some really good discounts from them. Unfortunately, we cannot disclose exactly how much we paid for the system, but what we can do is give you the actual cost of what the system brand new would cost.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm. So we went for the Huawei Smart PV. It is a 10 kilowatt inverter.
Yes.
We also got three lithium ion batteries, which are 5 kilowatts
each.
That gives us a 15 kilowatt battery system.
Mm-hmm.
The battery system also comes with a top plate, which is a regulator for the batteries, smart regulator.
Yes.
Plus, we also got a backup box system. That backup box allows us to have a backup load, because this is a grid-tied system where we are using both from the solar panels and from the batteries and from the grid. So it's a grid-tied system, so the backup box will have a backup load. So if the power does go down during the day or during the night, the backup box will switch it so that we have critical load going, where we have the fans keeping everything warm inside the greenhouse. We have heating lights in the chicken coop so the chickens won't freeze.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, we keep our fridges and
main things
running in the house.
Yes.
Over the last 3 months or 2 months here in Mongolia, the power has gone down 15 times. We had a bit of load shedding during December, so they have been cutting the power for 2 hours pretty much every day in different areas.
Yeah, 1 hour.
1 hour, sometimes two.
Yeah.
In different areas, which has been great since the power goes down, the backup box turns on and everything can run and we can still function properly, which is going to be great. Update on our experience with the Huawei smart PV system. I think that has really changed the way we use our electricity. We have a mobile app, which is FusionSolar.
Mm-hmm.
So we can basically see what our consumption is, how much is coming from the PV, how much is coming from the battery, how much from the grid, what our consumption is. We also have lots of statistics where we can see how much we are using per day, per month, at what time. So we can be very specific and very energy efficient,
mm-hmm.
and not just waste energy.
Yes.
On the average, our daily consumption is about 150 kilowatts per day.
Mm-hmm.
We have noticed the change definitely since we started the system in the beginning of December till kind of mid-January was kind of the worst.
Mm-hmm.
We were getting around 15%. We were using about 15% consumption from the solar panels. Now at the end of January, that has come up to about 20%. On a good sunny day, we are getting about using about 25% from solar, which is kind of what we expected. That is going to drastically change quite a lot, I think, in the summer.
Summertime is actually we are producing more electricity than we need.
Yeah. Last year, we looked at last year, how much electricity did we use during December?
Last year, about 816,400
tugru. Mm-hmm. For 1 month.
Yeah. And then in Mongolia, have like nighttime discount. And then like we paid 607,550 tugru.
Per month. Yeah.
Per month.
And this year?
With the solar system, around this time, at that time, 678,172
rug. And then with the discount.
And then with the discount, we paid in 464,922 rugs.
So that's about 150,000 rugs.
Which means
difference
about roughly 200,000.
And that's during the worst time. So of course this is going to increase quite a lot.
Mm-hmm.
In Mongolia, which you have a lot of places, they also have net metering. We have applied for the net metering. As soon as we get the approval, we'll be able to change our counting box so that can register exactly how much power we're actually giving to the grid. So during the summer, consuming a lot less, and we'll be giving to the grid a lot more. They're not going to give us money, but we will kind of collect points.
Yeah.
At nighttime when we don't have solar, we can take from that net metering and we can kind of build up credit the whole summertime so that and next winter
we could use that.
We could use those credits.
Yeah.
We don't exactly know how it's all going to work out, but we will keep you updated during the summer and during how it is next year and give you a full list of costs.
Yeah, that would be really interesting.
Yeah. How much was the smart PV inverter backup box? The batteries and that full setup.
Yeah. So, and one thing that the box, the counting box, that's counting in and out the both way.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. I mentioned that.
Oh, okay. Okay, so sorry. So, the all costs of inverter, it's a 5,100,000 tugru.
Yeah.
And Huawei battery, so we got three
batteries,
so which means 28,800,000 tugru.
Yeah.
Huawei backup box, 2,950,000 tugru, which means $863 about. The charge installation is 3,000,000 tugru.
Clean Resource Development, they can install the systems.
Mm-hmm.
And there is a charge for installing the system, which is 3,000,000.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't have to pay for the installation. That was quite nice of them. So that's really great. One thing to take into note with the installation is also you get a diagram of your system as well. So if you want to register with the government for your net metering, you need to supply them with a diagram of your whole system.
Yeah.
If you install the system yourself, because you can install the system yourself, it's a very DIY system, but you're still going to have to get
professional
papers, and that's quite expensive.
Yeah.
So in the
around about $3 million.
Yeah, exactly. So in the long run, the installation is worth it because you can also get the paperwork. So it makes sense.
Yeah. And also the more safety.
Yeah.
If you put all this system, solar panel, everything, and inverter, battery, all set up, and all the installation costs, and all together, $62,140,000 Turk, which means $18,185.
$18,000. It's going to be very up and down depending on what country you are. I think if you're doing the system in the States, it's quite a lot cheaper.
Mm-hmm.
But of course, in Mongolia, it can seem like quite a lot of money. There are very different ways to do solar. There are different batteries you can get. There are different inverters and things like that. Also to note that the Huawei system is a grid-tied system. It's not a complete off-grid.
Mm-hmm.
We can run off-grid. That's what the nice thing about the Huawei system. You can kind of have it whatever your setup is.
Mm.
That is really nice.
Yeah.
How much we will actually save on this system electricity-wise over a year? We are hoping that we can have pretty much a net zero electricity bill in a year. We don't know.
Yeah, we don't know.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how long it will take to pay off a system like this.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Fortunately, we got a little bit of a loan from a family member, Zula's dad, since we did not actually have the investment to invest in the system today.
Mm-hmm.
Great with her parents to help us out financially to put in a system like this.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, it's going to take us a couple of years to pay it off. But once it is paid off, it's only going to be beneficial.
Yeah.
And it's absolutely fantastic. We are so thankful for Clean Resource Development here in Mongolia that wanted to work with us so that we can help educate you of what it is like to build a solar system, to put in a solar system on your property and all the benefits that come with it. Because the most important is to look after the environment, especially here in Mongolia. Air pollution has been a huge problem. So if we can do anything to reduce our carbon footprint, it's definitely worth it.
Yes.
We will keep you updated during the year how the system functions, especially in the summer.
Mm-hmm.
And once we have the net metering in, and yeah. That's pretty much it, I think.
Timmy! Yes.
Really great to have the system in.
Mm.
If it is all possible, it is definitely worth investing in. I know some of the banks here in Mongolia, they do a green loan.
Yes.
So the repayments on the loan are extremely low. So they want to encourage you to take green loans so that you can reduce your carbon footprint here in Mongolia.
Yeah. You think it's just worth it, the having solar system, and especially that for echo, what's it called?
Reducing our carbon footprint.
Yeah.
I'm sure you guys are going to have lots more questions. We will try to answer that in the description.
Yeah. And also, if any more questions, and write down in the comments, and we will happy to answer for that.
Yeah, I think that's about it. Okay, guys, thank you so much, and we will see you in the next one.
See you next time.
Bye.
Hopefully it's good. What good information?
Hopefully, yes.
Hopefully.
Okay. Bye, guys. See you next time.
Bye-bye.